So we see that probability can essentially be thought of as a fraction. Okay, so it's a fraction of times that something happens. And so, in particular, a fraction of times that something happens is going to be between 0 and 1. Okay, and in particular, an impossible event, okay, something that never happens, is going to have probability 0. And an event that always happens, okay, event that always happens, we say that this event has probability 1. Okay? In general, in this course, when we model uncertainty, we're going to assume that there's some underlying experiment. Okay, and in the earlier coding example, the underlying experiment was flipping a coin. In general, we're going to say that an event happens with probability Q, where Q is between 0 and 1, inclusive, so it could be either 0 or 1 as well. An event happens with probability Q if in a massive number of repeats of the underlying experiment, the fraction of times event happens is roughly Q. Okay? It doesn't have to be exactly Q, it could be just roughly equal to Q. And in particular, more repeats of the experiment will make it so that the fraction of times the event occurs gets closer to Q. Okay, so this is what we mean when we say that an event happens with some probability Q. Of course, not every underlying experiment can actually be repeated. Okay, so take for example weather forecasting. In this particular problem, if today, so today was September 6, 2016, today it was cloudy and rainy around MIT. So, given all the weather patterns and whatnot up to today, we want to predict what the weather will be like tomorrow. Okay, so September 7th, 2016. We want to figure out what will the weather be. Of course, the underlying experiment here would be to wait a day and see what the weather is like tomorrow. Unfortunately, we can't actually repeat this underlying experiment. We would have to go back to September 6, 2016, and then wait a day to and so forth. So we would need a time machine to repeat this going from September 6 to September 7th to see what the weather is like. The only hope we have for trying to forecast what tomorrow's weather is going to be is to basically come up with some kind of model for how all the data we collect about weather up to today, how that relates to the weather tomorrow. An important point in this class is that how people model the same problem could be very different, and because people can come up with different probabilistic models, you can end up with different predictions. And a good model does not actually have to, for example, get the science of weather extremely accurate. A good model is going to enable us to make good predictions. So if a weather forecaster says that there is a 30% chance of rain tomorrow, then how we can interpret this result is that using however this forecaster is modeling or simulating weather, then in roughly 30% of the simulated results for tomorrow's weather, there is rain. Okay? So it's specific to how the forecaster is modeling or simulating weather. Okay, so in this sense, modeling uncertainty is a bit of an art.